Dear all, welcome to this video. Let's see in a short time how to use Apple Mail to manage and send emails with your Mac. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to get tips, discounts, and participate in our exclusive giveaways. Apple Mail is a built-in app inside macOS used to manage, send, and receive emails all in one place without accessing to multiple websites for each email account you have. It also includes editing tools for attachments and powerful rules against spam and phishing activities. At first, Apple Mail does not connect to any email account. To add any, go to Mail above and then to Add Account. Apple Mail is able to connect to several email providers automatically, including iCloud, Exchange as Hotmail, Google as Gmail, and many others such as Yahoo and AOL. For these accounts, it is sufficient to log in once, typing the email account and its password. Then, Apple Mail will retrieve all server information needed on its own. On other email providers, you have to specify account type and server addresses that can be found on their official websites. Check out our video description to find useful information on how to include these email accounts. Apple Mail lists all these email accounts on the left side with their own folders and starts syncing with each of these, downloading all the emails and attachments from each server. Once done, you can finally use Mail to send and reply to all your emails without logging in every time. The main interface is divided in three main sections, from the left side to the right. From the Mailboxes panel on the left, you can select any email account or any of its folders inside to check their content. These can also show any number indicating the number of unread emails inside, or a zap icon if these are offline. You can synchronize with the email servers anytime by using the first button in the top left corner. On top, the Mailboxes section collects the main folder shared among all the email accounts connected, such as Inbox for all the emails received and Sent for the ones you have sent. You can also create your own folders by using the plus button on the right, specifying where to save it on location and its name. At this point, you can drag and drop any email from the central column to such folder to store it. In addition, you can define smart mailboxes to create special folders collecting just the emails following specific rules, very useful to avoid spam and junk emails. When clicking on the plus button next to smart mailboxes, specify the name for such folder and below each single rule per row that must be respected, defining the sender as from, any subject, or the email status. Above, select all to follow all the rules together, or any to have only one rule respected to get the email moved in such smart mailbox. The central column shows all the emails inside the selected folder from the left, sorted by date and hour. On top, you can change their order by subject, senders, or attachment presence, and also see just the unread emails, which have a blue marker on the left side. Each email shows the sender name in bold, its subject, and then a short preview of their content. On the right, you can check the reception date and hour, and the email account that received the email. On the left, the email can get other icons indicating if it has been forwarded or it has attachments. If you do not find any email, you can use the Search tab on the right, which gives useful suggestions on several categories. You can also search for all the emails from the same sender, typing from plus name or all the ones sent to the same recipient with to plus name. To write a new email, use the second button in the top left corner. On to, specify the recipients, typing directly or using the plus button on the right to search from your saved contacts list. On CC, you can put people in copy and inside from, set the email account to use to send the email, adding any title for such email on subject. From the button on top, you can show other useful fields, such as BCC, to put people in copy but not shown to the recipients, and reply to define another email address collecting all the replies from the recipients. On priority field, set the email importance. Once the header above is set, type the email content at the bottom. You can drop special characters by holding down any key and change the text format, style, color, or add any list by using the A button on top. Use emoji and symbols to apply social emojis and the attachment button to include any file within your email. These appear with their name and size and can be removed with the backspace key, as you do with the text content. When adding or receiving images and PDF documents as attachments, these get open on the email directly. You can also edit and draw on these by hovering over these and going to Markup. Here you can drop freehand sketches, regular shapes and arrows, pieces of text, and even signatures from the trackpad. Each of these elements can be edited in line width, stroke, and fill color, and also in font family and style. Click on Done to apply. Right below the subject, you can check the message size and change the image size if you need. In the top right corner, you can take photos and make sketches from any iPhone or iPad connected to your Mac. This way, you can directly attach these to your email in no time. To send the current email, use the Send button. If you are not ready yet, you can close the window and go to Save to move the email to the Draft folder in order to check and send it later. To read any email content, just select it from the center and check on the right side. You can also double-click on it to open it on a new window. Attached images and PDF files get open on the email, but you can also download these by hovering over the attachment icon and going to Save All. On top, you have several buttons to manage the selected email. Use Archive to store the email inside the Archive folder. Use Delete or Junk to move the email to the Bin or the Junk folder, using Command and Z to undo this action. Then click on Reply to reply to the sender of the email, Reply to All to reply to both the sender and all the people in copy, and Forward to send the email to different people not present in To or CC fields. You can also flag the email to mark it and add it to the flagged folder. Whereas to move the email from the current folder to another one, you can either use Move To above or drag and drop it on another folder on the left. With Apple Mail, you can save your contacts list not to remember email addresses every time. Next to any email address, click on the small arrow and go to Add to Contacts. This way, you do not have to type this email address entirely, using the suggestions from Apple Mail or finding the address inside the contacts list. You can choose Block Contact to block the email address. This restriction can be managed anytime from the Junk Mail section inside Preferences. Thanks for watching this tutorial. Discover our channel for more and free content on other outstanding software for Mac and Windows.